Greetings and salutations, everyone. This is Siltalent coming to you live on 1/5/2023. Today we'll be playing some EverQuest. We're going to be going into Miss MMM. We'll be then doing a couple other raids alongside of it to pan out the rest of the evening. So we'll be hitting up Blood Moon Keep and Soul Bleeder for more fat loots. So we'll see what we get for what they determine to do tonight after we finish up MMM for the first time. So sit back, relax, enjoy. We are currently making our way to Fort Mech and over to MM to start up the raid. We got the buffs done and all that, so here we go. Someone loves their doom bugs.
You're right. That mech coming out of this fog is really crazy.
Yeah, you're right. Did look a little creepy. What's the lore behind the Mecha?
Some gnome got added to the world and destroy all the humanity.
And it wound up being a big joke. Yep, slackers get to take the banner. Well, if you poured yourself a glass of wine, you can enjoy your wine. Was that Cabernet or Gabernet? Ah. I don't drink, so I have no idea on that stuff.
Okay, so I think we have who's going. If you're not going for the raid, if you had offered to sit or if you were asked to, unfortunately, drop the raid and talk to Brenna. Make sure you get your DKP for tonight. And take them to the raid chat because we'll try to maintain the habit of posting what we get during the raid for people to bid on. Because we can only swap you in and out if you want to bid not in the raid. So yeah, just message her and the rest of you wait for the banner if you're not there yet. We'll head in and get going. Feel free to, you know, holler out Discord or field chat and see what it is.
All right. What we're going after in MMM is the last two bosses that we have not killed. Mr. Moore himself and one other boss. I believe the boss that we're going to be taking down is the one that's sleeping in a bed that we have to wake up and do a whole bunch of shenanigans with and kill slavers and bloody block the stuff that's trying to get to him. Ah, so much fun.
Attacks when you take.
All right, so tonight I am opening with 76 DKP. In we go. Meldress Shake and Bake Adventure. Hey, McWarrior, how's it going, man? We're back in the I cannot believe it's a raid channel again. Hit EverQuest. Not too bad. We had another snow day with work. So I played more in the morning for some EQ stuff and kind of got a little lazy in the afternoon and evening.
Yeah, that door box.
But overall, not bad. This will be our first time clearing MMM tonight. We're killing off a boss that we have killed before. Then we're going to be doing the final boss of the instance. And we're pretty excited about that. Oh, wow. Nice. Yeah, green steel. What are they making? Elf ar elf armor? Ah, kind of figured as much. Elven armor. I'm surprised they didn't have you put the intricacies into it, such as the kind of like leaf style metal etchings.
Welcome. The elevator?
Oh, wow. Oh, nice. They must have probably been scoping you out for the work to do for quite a while. That's what they should have named him, honestly, the lazy ass Minotaur.
Make sure that you stop them, kill them, dispel the charm person,
Oh, wow.
We'll also see periodically picture cars go active. You'll see a bigger boat from them. We'll tell the engine cars to charge us. They'll become active, start passing towards the center. We need to get in their way. That's going to theoretically induce this. Quite right. But the idea is we get in the way. It triggers a 5K DD and stun. When you see those engine cars start moving, or when you see the boat, the engine cars charge, get in the way. And the other major mechanic here is a tank mechanic to do weapon swaps. So depending on where he goes in the weapon racks, switch things around. If he goes to the west, he'll equip swords, tank needs a one-hit blunt, one-hit slash. If he goes kind of center, but still on the west side, he's going to get axes, tank needs a two-hit slash. If he goes to the center east, he's going to equip gears, tank needs two one-hit slashes. And if he goes to the far east, he needs a one-hand of any kind.
You'll do the best that you can, which is actually pretty good.
We don't want to get that wrong.
You have quality work regardless. Hopefully the armor set will fit him.
Double check your buffs. Make sure you've got the first slots of the can. And with that, if we're going to make that corner, do we have the eyes under?
They're on their way out.
As far as assist goes, do you want me switching over to the Pentators when they move, or what?
Okay.
And just for my sanity, that's any time those guys move, you need to get in front of them.
Busty Knight. The busty Elven Knight. So you call that a bust knight? Sorry, bad joke. But I'm glad that I hear that he praised your work quite well and it'll fit them. That's really good, really, really, really good advertisement that you don't have to pay for at all.
And with that, looks like the guys are done. We'll play the burn fight here. I guess this will be around. Might be something around for the first time.
Ah, nice. Indeed. She must have paid a pretty penny for the suit. Slaver. Slavers. Slavers. Yeah, 1 second. This fight is a little intuitive. I'll get back to what you're talking about in a bit.
Yeah, nearly move up.
My pet's bugged. There we go. Okay, we're down to the last 10%. There we go. Got it. See what loot we got. Second. All right. Yeah, that's a different type of armoring, but you do more of the traditional armors. Do we have the arms? And they are tier 1, and I can bring them to tier 3. I have enough money for that.
So am I reading that right? It's not going to lower mana regen at all?
Right.
And
there is the only one that lowers right now. The last one
Okay, thank you.
10 is the highest I'm going to go. Surprised that there is people with,
Root spitting, by the way.
Oh well. I am not going to bid any further.
Do you want to ask folks as you with these runes, double check that you actually need them? Update your loot filters as you get what you need.
I mean, for you, I mean, what you do is what you do. That's your choice. Yes, a lot of the elven armor from the movies that you see is a little bit ridiculous. How does it protect anyone? Oh, it's got magic shielding to help do that. That's their explanation of, well, this is technically a skimpy dress that looks like armor. But traditionally, armor provides protection to the body, not just some mystical forces that says, oh, it blocks stuff. No wonder why the elven archers fall so fast in melee combat. They literally don't have any armor. They might as well give them tissue paper and call it body armor. Oh, that's funny. But I see what you mean. You actually doing traditional body armor, elven armor. Traditional archer armor, yes, that makes sense for you because you want to keep it more in line with what really functions and works. But the movie armors, yeah, they can be kind of laughable. No practicality to it. I mean, the bikini wearing berserkers, yeah. Oh, this chain bikini over my groin and breast are going to save me from multiple slashes and cuts from the enemy. Like, that's like, is that where they're aiming? You do practical armor. That makes, yeah, I mean, if you make practical armor, you make practical armor. If you don't make movie armor, you don't make movie armor. That's the armorsmith's choice. That's your choice to do that if you want. Shoot. Had him up already. I mean, you're the person building the stuff, so you have your preferences, you have your choices. The customer has to agree to it, whether or not that they want to purchase equipment from you. Oh, sorry. I didn't notice it. Let's see. That was yesterday.
So yeah, we need to make our way to the third floor. We have a puller that is familiar with that. Just start leading the way and let us know if we're going to run into stuff.
Okay. Sorry, I noticed it, and by the time I noticed it, I thought you already did what you did. No, we've already did breakneck. The elevators are now accessible. They're just trying to find the way to go to get to Meldrath from here. No, we're not locked out. You get locked out if you don't get to the second floor to deal with Breakneck. Once you defeat Breakneck, the elevators become active again. Breakneck stops the elevators from functioning. And if you're not on the second level, see? Yeah, Meldrath's next. We've already done Breakneck. That's where we're able to punch through the doors without using eyes and monks. Yeah, it can get confused a little bit. I was a little confused at first, too, but figured it out. 'Cause we were going up and down the elevator. That sounds interesting.
Also going to raise 16 corruption counter. And if we do not get it here, I will be a 15k AE on the priest. Good news there, you're able to cure the corruption itself, just to make sure you have that up. While we're dealing with him, I'm going to be spawning abs all the way through. We're going to start with killing the one that kind of looks like a tombstone. Then there are TikToks that are non-hostile. They're going to give you an emote targeting someone. Basically, we need that person to run away from the ring. And I think last in the end are emergency repair mechanics. Those will pop up in the south at Fort Snellgrass. If they heal, or if they reach him, they heal about 20%. We don't want that to happen. And so if we see those, we'll get those. So, Tombstone Thing, Patrick Liberators, then Turks and Air Mechanics, and then Void. Where we're getting targeted by the other things. And then, if a player dies, Void, a 4-minute Redman spawns, hit about 7k. Kind of be once they start rolling. If the player gets red, the ad dies. Really, the best way to handle those is first try not to die, but if you do, get a red level. So while we're dealing with all those, we're going to beat down Melgrath. Spawn. Big Dot Ore is going to fill the room so we're going to get out quick. So he spawns, I don't know. Get up, head up, and then we'll wait to get the second half, so don't run too far. Right out of the room and away from Aura, get up the ads, I can stop.
Wow, it's a double phase fight. Defeat him one way, then we got to get out of the room, deal with the ads, and go back in for the second part. This is going to be interesting. So we are fighting Meldreth. This is a multi-pronged fight. The first round of fighting, we're going to be dealing with a bunch of adds, different mechanics going off, about four different ones that throughout the fight. Once we get done with this part of the fight, we have to back out of the room, finish the adds, and then we can re-met up, and then we go in for the second fight. So this is a double fight mechanic. If people die in the raid at one point, they become they spawn a reverent that hits pretty hard. The only way to kill the reverent is to res the person who died. So it's something that we really, really don't want happening. So this is kind of a no death fight. as best we can take it. There are NPCs in the raid that will target people by calling them out. That person has to run away from the raid. So, since it's steampunk era, pistol, you could make it have, like, turning gears on the pistol and a little bit of steam coming out of it using dry ice. So it looks like it's pressurized steam pistol ready to shoot out. And if you want to be a little cheeky about it, you can have the dry ice puff out when they pull the trigger. So all they need is a little chunk of dry ice that gets a little bit of water dripped on it as it's inside the chamber. So the gun is kind of smoking, and when you pull the trigger, puffs out steam. The dry ice, you know, make it look like it fired. This if you wanted to go that far with it. Ah, that could be too. Oh, nice.
Yeah, I'm in the southwest corner.
Oh, yeah, then my options go in A to B, southwest.
But he doesn't have any sharks. That's not bad.
Eight rangers.
Oh, shoot. Meant to look at it, not turn it off. Oh, well.
We have
Sunday evening.
You want us to go back around? So,
we have to call.
Let's put a knife in a cage. Have a cage stand next to it for us. And then what we're going to do is the knife is going to cut in.
It off with cockler. So, healers are supposed to be dropping the wood and then the wall and the wall.
And turn the doors off.
Alright, we're getting ready to do this.
Could we do a weapon shield split? We do have 17 features if we can split it out.
Yeah, then the range is going to have to die, though. Perfect. Okay, so here's, so I see the east northeast, other is northwest. So what we'll do is drill in your phone, but not yet. I'm gonna have you
Yeah, real quick.
he's gonna pass through us.
I mean, they hit. Yeah, they hit.
Pretty tight the corner. Right up.
Pretty tight the corner.
Right up.
Pull them both to a corner, the DDA, and then somebody pulls the rat six cut off, like a knight, or a page, or whatever you guys have.
I can pull six cut off. I will. I mean, it looks like you have that half back. Leave the south.
Hey, sorry, quick question. What corner are we tanking the 6-ton? I'll grab the 6-ton path right back this way. And that goes to the corner, so you have to tank the last corner. So yeah, I'll grab the path this way. Yep. I would say so, because otherwise people have to be able to get back up a little bit towards the door. Well, then we'll move. I'm still in position to get his attention when he needs it to. Well, 6+2.
How long is the puppy?
Where would you sit without a spike? He's got a spike.
I kind of wish to see him.
To be clear, no one's going to tag Melgraf, but he's going to tag Melgraf. And then I should tag 6-ton to tag him back.
So what we're trying to do is split these two up so we can kill 6-ton by 6-ton first and then jump on Meldraft, because it seems that 6-ton is not aggroed with Meldraft by himself. So it's kind of a little bit of trickery. All right, they're getting ready to do the poll. So now we have them path back. As they're pathing back, we can grab nice.
Perfect.
Man, yeah.
Stay in the on the other wall.
Balbro Mass Group buff used. Balbro Mass Group buff used. Brynna Mass Group buff used. Brynna Mass Group buff used. Fire Tamer Mass Group buff used. Fire Tamer Mass Group buff used.
Wow, my water's bugged. Hey, emergency repair mechanics.
Thank you.
Wow. Sounds like you're going to be having a lot of fun with the steampunk stuff. I still think having like a little chamber of where dry ice goes in with water dripping on the dry ice to cause steam to come up from a component area of the rifle would look really cool. It only activate the drip part when it's leveled, but when it's, you know, hanging back or hanging down, there's not enough water to go through the little hole to drip. Or they could just pour a little water in a special thing. First of two phases done. Time to met up from here.
Run on Silv Talon. Run on Silv Talon.
Thanks. You're going to have to look at, do they have pictures of these supposed weapons that you're going to reference off of? Or are you just going to make something just out of your own imagination? As long as you have some type of reference to work with and then use your imagination from there, that'll work too. Make it unique. Ah, okay. You've seen steampunk stuff before, right? It's kind of like clockwork gears, and very zany stuff.
Run on Silv Talon.
It's unique looking in itself. Yeah. Exactly. With a very strong emphasis on steam engine era. Now, what you could do is to make it really unique, is make the rifle, but make it set up so it can have an attachment on it that goes to a hose and to a backpack or a couple hoses that has a really unique steampunk-looking era backpack, which is you could say it's the power generator to make it a rapid-fire rifle. So what you do is you have the rifle as they requested, and then as a bonus in which they could pay for as well, they can get the backpack with that too. So it gives it a really unique look. So it could be either like a standard rifle, and then the backpack is like a massive energy source that makes it into a rapid fire heavy hitting rifle, like a heavy rifle. Yeah, you can also make it part of, hey, this backpack goes with the suit. Kind of give them, you could do that, kind of give them the etching of what the suit's going to look like. Yeah. Then if you made the backpack have kind of whirling clock noises and a little bit of steam, kind of blowing out with a little low whistle, that would be cool too. There's so much you can do with that backpack. Whirling cogs and all that. Wow. I would have so much fun with that. I would have way too much fun with that. Make the backpack based around a radiator. The core of the backpack is a radiator that's been modified with all the shenanigans. Uh.
Run on Sylvetalon. Run on Sylvetalon.
Very nice. And, you know, you can actually top it off with a suit-wise, is you can kind of give it a classic-y, classic era, kind of, suit effect, you know what I mean, over the scrapper
run on
outfit.
Sylvetalon.
So it kind of has
run
a,
on Sylvetalon.
A high society look to it. There's so many things, ways you can put it and do it. That's nice. But definitely, that'll be interesting to see what you design. When you get it done, the rifle and all that, and the guns, snap a picture and show me. I'd love to see the work. Yeah, I'd love to really see what you have on your imagination there. Oh, yeah. And creativity.
Run on Sylvetalon. Run on Sylvetalon.
Hey, no worries, man. But it'll be fun to see it, though. I'm just saying. True, true enough. Let's see.
What's the kill order? The target? Really put the first one?
On first. Well, we need two of these first. And
very nice. Well, have fun at the fair then. So it looks like that all the old bosses that we just killed in the instance are going to make a reappearance. Oh, nice. You're going to make a lot of those other vendors very jealous. All right, we're ready to do Mildraff 2.0 now. We're about to start this in a moment. They're finishing up the last coordinations. Here we go.
DA on end.
Let me know when you want a Paragon. A lot of stuff in here.
Duck Silt Talon. Check for existing timer. Save to stand. Save to stand. Save to stand. FD fail. FD fail. FD fail. FD fail. FD fail. FD fail.
My focus is on the group over DPS right now, because we have people just dropping. Firing MBG
Duck
right
Silt
now.
Talon. FD fail. 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 Check for existing timer. Save to stand. Save to stand. Save to stand. FD fail. FD fail.
There we go. That'll be Scrubs.
Stewart Mass Group buff used. Stewart Mass Group buff used.
Scrubs, you're up.
Janine Mass Group buff used. Janine Mass Group buff used.
Mine's been going on, Andy, the whole time.
Dark Shots Mass Group buff used. Dark Shots Mass Group buff used. Lothar Mass Group buff used. Lothar Mass Group buff used.
Trying to get healers met up back again. So we're trying to get healers up in mana. Yep, I'm using, sorry.
Thanks, Prim.
Hold the focus is where Scrubs is going to throw out his mass group here in a moment. Is Raibu's focus down? Andres is down here. All right, Scrubs, you're good to go, I believe. What the heck is going on? He's not listening. Oh well. I have to get her focused. He's taking too long. Well, not going to count on Scrubs for MBG Paragon. He's not using it when I'm telling him to. Woo, Stuart died fast.
Oaken Mass Group buff used. Oaken Mass Group buff used. Thalrin Mass Group buff used. Thalrin Mass Group buff used. Webdar Mass Group buff used. Webdar Mass Group buff used. Run on Sylvetalon. Run on Sylvetalon.
Expecting some explosions on me. Haven't gotten hit.
Scrubs mass group buff used. Scrubs mass group buff used. Sebok mass group buff used. Sebok mass group buff used. Drua mass group buff used. Drua mass group buff used. And mass group buff used. And mass group buff used. Ida's mass group buff used. Ida's mass group buff used.
Guess I can go back in. Something exploded. Nice. Nice job, everyone. Meldreth down. We lost a lot of people in the raid due to
Sylvetalon, you woke him up.
Because of the duck mechanic from one of the
Sylvetalon,
mobs.
Sylvetalon, you woke him up.
And their Genas didn't trigger it for some odd reason.
Sylvetalon, you woke him up.
Am I on the wrong one? No, I'm not. Well done, everyone. Well done. It's our first time killing them, by the way, guys. We'll see what type of loot we got off all that. There we go. That's all the stuff that we got off this guy. Very nice.
You're gonna do mess. You go somewhere or
is everyone rezzed? Throwing out SC2. We didn't get the bow. Not enough rangers died. We didn't get the bow. That's funny. All right, we'll be doing Blood Moon and Soul Eater as our next targets, possibly. We're just going to see where it's going to go at. Right now we're rebuffing, getting loot out, and seeing where things go, as well as who gets what for the key unlocks. I still have one more Crystallis wing to run in order to finish up that part, and then I need this oil slick to be able to get into Crystallis raid. So it's going to be quite interesting. I'll probably get it on the third time we do MMM fully. Or the last person. Who knows? It's not a big deal. But we're gonna it's gonna take us 4 weeks just to be able to get in Crystallis. So this is our first week, so 3 more weeks needed. It's because of the flagging. They should have actually made it so the raid is flagged to help the progression go pretty much faster. What should they have done? They should have made it so when you got to this point, you got the key for what you needed from here to get into Crystallis. Instead of cutting it, only 1/4 of your raid can get in at a time. That's so stupid. But then again, this was a release that was meant to run for an entire year before they released another X-Pack. But because we're doing TPL... TPL time frame is much, much shorter. the old system that they had in place is irrelevant. They need to update it. But EverQuest's spaghetti code, because it's so old, that probably making that type of change would affect a lot of things throughout the game from here on out. That would, who knows what the effect would have. We're going to be doing Soul Bleeder next.
That dude mass group buff used. That dude mass group buff used.
Andre, sit down. Andy. Yeah, it's a can of Pringles. Hey, at least it never fails. I usually screw up a reference here and there. Almost done with Companion's Fury. Holy cow. I've been just dumping AA after AA into this skill. It's insane. On how many... It's all. I feel like I dumped at least 100 AA points just in this one skill. Right now. From what I went up from. Level 31 to 38. Ugh. All loot's been given out. Sweet. ATL's going out. Is the guild standard at DHS?
Runs with Wolves Mass Group Buff Used. Runs with Wolves Mass Group Buff Used.
Okay, we're heading to Hills of Shade right now.
I just did now, yeah. He says fuck off. What do you want to do as well? That's right, I'm going to stand by. Oh. What? How would you do that? He told me to tell you.
All right, MechWarrior, you take care and have a good night. Thanks for watching, man. Appreciate it. And good luck with your steampunk guns and other stuff. Very nice. It's a zombie party. Wow. Now, all we're waiting for is the rest of the people to show up, and then we'll get this event going. It's a very easy event, honestly. Easy to get your T3 wrist cores. Wow. Don't know why I get so tired around this time. It is late. All right, there we go. Lot of small garbage to deal with. Cut through this pretty fast. We'll be pretty much heading through here, up around here, down through here, through here, through here, and like this. And then we'll clear to here. And then we'll go in here, start the event, fight out around here, and go back. Should be pretty easy and simple. The butterflies. The butterfly effect. Still got my ring upgrading and my belt. Belt's already on, like, what, tier 2? Level 2? Yeah, it's on level 2 going to 3. And my ring is at level 2 going out of 3. Great. We're going to have a ton of ads coming in at us.
Ribu Mass Group buff used. Ribu Mass Group buff used.
Go. Very nice. See what we get off this in a moment. All right. We got nice little magic item. That's nice. These are both cores. Huh, double core. Looks to be it. Double same core, so clerics and shamans. And then a couple runes. This is one of the easiest raids you can do. I mean, it is so easy. It's a good way to get a nice T3 wrist if you're willing to pay 30 to 60K for it, depending on if you have to recore. I had a recore, so it cost me 60K, but this is what it looks like. Then I got that in there. All right.
Lothar mass group buff used.
Rolled out.
Lothar mass group buff used.
Who gets a rune tonight? I've only gotten two runes so far, and I need, like, what, 27? Oh, this nobody's going to get all their runes, I can tell you that. Nobody will by the time we have the expansion change. So we had one new boss kill. We finished up two bosses, Meldrum Mansion, and we finished this guy. Did I even roll? Yeah, I did. A 2. Wow, if it was lowest roll, I would have gotten that. It's so funny. And a 107. Yep, dice gods hated me tonight. Oh, you little bastards. That wasn't too bad. I don't think we're going to be doing anything else tonight, probably, since it's so close to when we usually end. Let's see, what is the next raid schedule looking at on Saturday? Okay, Saturday the 7th. We're going to be doing Steam Factory, Deep Scar, and Tin Miser. Ah, we're going to do the first Moon Bloodkeep raid. All right, we're heading to Blood Moon Keep, guys. We get one more raid in. This is going to be pretty fast, about 20 minutes, a 20-minute raid here, once we get it started. So Blood Moon Keep we go. All we need to do is just wait for the instance to start up. You're just finishing up the soul bleeder part. Nope. Clicked on this. Let's click back out.
Can everyone else just meet outside of the Blood Moon Keep? If we get instance, text box asking if we want to search it back instead of the crate.
Do we all need to kick the task? Now we're going to do the first Blood Moon Keep event, and then pretty much get that done pretty fast. Should be very easy, but it's fun. It's more free loot. It's tier 1 loot, by the way. Where do we get chests and legs from? One or two. Man, this instance always puts me to sleep because of this background soundtrack to it, the music. It just seems so, like, lazy. The last two items I need for is chests and legs. Because I pretty much got everything else that I need. For a tier gear for visible. Okay. Vestin will spawn adds every 25%. The longer he's up, the harder he hits. He'll spawn wargs, which can be mezzed, and the were-orcs we can kill. That'll be the first boss. And then the second boss we kill, we then get loot.
FD fail. Cimadine Mass Group Buff Used. Cimadine Mass Group Buff Used. Vexed Mass Group Buff Used. Vexed Mass Group Buff Used. Tussle Mass Group Buff Used. Tussle Mass Group Buff Used.
Just go through and kill all the ads now. We get no loot for this fight, but we will get loot at the end, which is our next fight. Too many left. Baguette.
Bajet Mass Group Buff Used. Bajet Mass Group Buff Used.
And mine is up now. So the next fight is going to be a balance fight. And lots of ads. Very nice. Okay, we'll see what we get. This is our last target of the evening. Let's see what loot we got. We got pants. What do I have for? Oh, this is slightly worse, slightly bad. Nah, I'm not gonna bother with it. Ooh, nice. It's about 60k. If you have the core, it's around 30k. If you don't have the right core, but you have a different core, it's 60k. Yeah.
Website says, but I went there and it was like 30 to 35. It was that for the replacement piece for not having tier 1, tier 2.
Ah, gotcha.
So it's like 60k total if you have to adjust the steam gyro.
Alright.
Steam core, whatever.
Yeah, that sucks. I thought it was for the replacement for the tier 1, tier 2. I thought it was the 13.
Yeah, that's wrong, I guess.
If you have the proper core, it's 30k. If you don't have the proper core and you have to readjust it, and you have to buy the mold, it's 60k.
That's all I did.
They want it that bad, I'll let them have it. I wanted to get it, but they wanted it that bad, seeing the type of jump they did, I'll let them have it. That's a good indication of, no, don't bid any higher. All right. They probably have something less than me. So, I'll get the next one. Try to. But legs and chest are the only two that I need right now. For the armor loots. This would have been a really nice upgrade. By quite a bit. Alright, I want to thank people for watching us play some EverQuest this evening. It's been a lot of fun entertaining you. Hopefully you enjoyed it. With that being said, our next night will be on Saturday night. We'll be going in and doing some more flagging quests for people to get them all the items that they need to get into MMM. It looks like we're getting some more boxes in. That'll be kind of interesting. So we're going to do those raids to get some nice loots off that as well. In addition, We'll be picking up with more MMM, and as we get closer to getting enough time, we will be able to hit up Crystalis as a raid target. So that's what we're shooting for. With that being said, if you like what you see, please hit that follow button. And I thank you for watching tonight. Have a good night. Be safe and be well. Still Talon out. Oh, hold on. I'm not going to cut it yet. Yeah, I do too. That's why when she bidded 15, I stopped immediately. That was a clear indicator that she probably needed it. But anyways, that's why I let it go, because if someone jumps 10 points up for like that fast, it's like, yeah, they probably need it more than I do. So that's why I let it go. Anyways, peace out. Have a good night, everyone.